In this video, we will study the concept command line arguments. So what is command line argument? They are arguments, or you can say parameters, supplied to the program when program is invoked. That means instead of giving the input from the program internally or by the user when user executing program, we can give input to the program at the start of program execution by using command line argument. It is possible to pass some values from the command line to your program when they are executed. These values are called command line arguments, and many times they are important for your program, especially when you want to control your program from outside instead of giving values inside the program code. Every C program will have one main function, and command line arguments are handled using main functions arguments. So here there will be two arguments that main function takes: argc and argv. So argc is of type integer, and it is used to count the number of arguments passed to the program using command line, whereas argv is array and its data type is char, which holds the number of arguments passed through command line. And one more thing is that argv array is a pointer variable which points to each argument passed to the program. Now we will see how to pass arguments using command line. In C program, first we write a program using any text editor, and after writing the program, we save that program using .c extension. Suppose the program name is program1, then you have to save that by giving the name program1.c. So after finishing our program, we will compile that program. There are number of compilers available to compile the program. You can use any compiler. Once your program is free from errors, you can go for program execution. So by using command prompt, you can supply arguments to the program. All the arguments supplied through command line will be saved in pointer variable argv, and you can supply number of arguments. There is no limit for supplying arguments. So to supply command line argument, first you have to write program name, then after you can give number of arguments you want. Each argument should be separated by space with each other. So this is example of passing arguments through command line. So here we have passed 4 arguments, and it will be saved in array with name argv. So this is the graphical structure of array argv. So the first argument, that is name of program, will be stored in argv of 0. So argv of 0 will hold the value program1.c. Next argument, that is ds, will be stored in argv of 1. Next argument, that is 12, will be saved in argv of 2. Next argument, that is 7.21, will be saved in argv of 3. So we have passed 4 arguments here by using command line, and argument argv is used to count the number of arguments supplied through command line. So argc will hold the value 4, and we have supplied 4 arguments. First argument will be always a program name. After that, we have supplied ds, then 1, 2, and last one is 7.21. Remember that all these values are saved as string, because data type of argv is char. So 1, 2 is not integer, it is a string, and even 7.21 is not a floating number, it is string. So if you want to use these values as a integer or floating number, you have to convert that into their respective data type by using the type conversion method. Now we will see one small example which shows how we write arguments of main function, which are used to store arguments supplied by command line. So if you see main function, in brackets we have written 2 arguments, that is argc is of type integer, which is used to count number of arguments, and argv array, which is a pointer variable that holds the values supplied through command line. So in this way, we can use command line argument in C language.